TaleForges. In this video, we'll learn about player jump in Unity ECS. Of course, we want to use physics to learn even more about ECS. So let's dive in and see how I implemented this feature. To handle the jump, we need to do three things. Listen for the action, assign a state, and depending on the state, handle the logic. First of all, let's add new action to InputControls asset. Let's name it jump and select binding path to keyboard space. Don't forget to save asset. Okay, let's go to IDE and select the player input system script that we prepared in the previous lectures. Let's add handling for jump input in set player map actions. Player map actions dot jump dot perform plus equal on jump perform. Create the necessary private void method with the input callback parameter. Don't forget to unsubscribe in the onDestroy method. Next, let's implement the logic in onJumpPerform. We need to get the player singleton entity to get the player aspect. And now we want to write player aspect dot is jump equals true. We haven't created this field yet, but we will in a moment. Let's go to the player movement component data and create a new public bool field called isJump. Now change script to player aspect, add new property public bool isJump. Get equals to player movement component data dot value read only dot isJump. Set equals to player movement component data dot value read write dot isJump equals value. Great. Also, we need to store somewhere JumpForce value. So move to player component data and add a new public float field called JumpForce. Let's jump to PlayerAuthoring class, add serialized field JumpForce and getter. Then invoker pass JumpForce to player component data. One last thing. Let's add a getter in player aspect to be able to retrieve JumpForce from the player movement system. Okay, let's implement jump logic. First of all, we want to refactor names, set rotation change to set player rotation, and set velocity to handle player move. Now we need to check if player is jumping, so let's write if player aspect is jump, handle jump, return. Of course, let's create a public void method and add two parameters, physics velocity, player velocity, and player aspect, player aspect. Remember to add burst compy attribute. Also pass parameters to handle jump. What is next? We need to apply impulse force to the player. So let's take a look at the documentation. Go to methods tab and find apply linear impulse. This one below, we don't need body scale. As you can see, to do linear impulse, we need to have rev physics velocity, which means read write axis, physics mass and impulse force. Okay, let's back to the code and change the execute method's physics velocity parameter from in to rev. Also add the in physics mass parameter. Now pass rev player velocity and physics mass to handle jump method. Of course, change the parameters accordingly. In the handle jump, let's write player velocity dot apply linear impulse As you can see, it is from Unity Physics Extensions. And pass physics mass, PlayerAspect.JumpForce multiply by math.app. Math.app is float free equivalent of the vector free.app. At the end, write PlayerAspect.isJump equals false. Let's go to Unity. Go to player prefab and set jump force to 75. Also set the rigid body inertia on X and Y to infinity. This will prevent strange rotation behavior for the rigid body. Okay, hit play and let's jump. As you can see, the jump works. However, we can also jump in the air. And that's something we'll fix in the next video. I would like to invite you to support us on Patreon. Even a small contribution will help us to develop the channel and the quality of the content present. Also, I invite you to Discord and other social media. Links in the description. Thank you for your time. I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.